ശിവഗിരി തീർത്ഥാടന മഹാമഹത്തിന്റെ ഭാഗമായുള്ള ബ്രഹ്മ വിദ്യാലയ കനക ജൂബിലി സമ്മേളനം ഉദ്ഘാടനം ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ട് ഗവർണർ ആരിഫ് മുഹമ്മദ് ഖാൻ സംസാരിക്കുന്നു. തൽസമയ സംരക്ഷണത്തിലേക്ക്.
ആ സമ്മേളനത്തിന്റെ ലക്ഷ്യവും ഗുരു വ്യക്തം ആക്കി വാദിക്കാനും ജയിക്കാനും അല്ല അറിയാനും അറിയിക്കാനും ഉള്ള വേദി. ഭഗവത്ഗീത, ബൈബിൾ, ഖുർആൻ എന്നിവയുടെ തത്വങ്ങൾ ദിവസവും ചർച്ച ചെയ്യും ഈ ബ്രഹ്മവിദ്യാലയം. അറിയാനും അറിയിക്കാനും ഉള്ള മാതൃക സ്ഥാനം ആണ്. I have been informed that the main objective behind the establishment of this institution was the study and propagation of Guru's principles and vision. Along with this, Gurudev had suggested to ensure facilities to study the main teachings of all major religions, different traditions. At that time, that is in 1924, Guru had aimed to raise 5 lakh rupees for this Brahma Vidyalaya. Guru's idea was to select as brahmacharis the youth with an aptitude for ascetic life, to impart sannyas to the qualified and truly inclined among them, and to send them to work for society. Paropkarartha priyatnam. The Brahma Vidyalayam is realization of Guru's dream of having a place to teach the principles of all religions to students irrespective of their religion. I am absolutely delighted to be here, and I express my gratitude for the invitation to come and inaugurate the Golden Jubilee celebrations of Brahma Vidya. I have the written speech ready with me, but I want to depart from them because Swamiji, the previous speakers, have said so many things which touch your heart, which show the path to this world which is torn with problems. The very name Brahm Vidyalaya, Atmanam Vidhi, know yourself, as Pujya Swamiji has elaborated this. Actually, this is the teaching which comes to us from our ancient rishis, our thought leaders. We have forgotten about it, and that is why we need a Swami Vivekananda, we need a Sri Guru Narayan, we need these Swamijis to remind us about our heritage. If we really understand the significance of the teaching and live up to those teachings, we can not only solve our own problems, but we can show the path to the world. We can pave the way for a new world order which will be free from the tensions which we witness today because of difference of different religions, different traditions. The modern West has given the concept of dignity of mankind. It is not very old, not even 150 years old. But that concept of dignity of mankind has spurred the world. And the world has accepted the concept of, based on that basic principle of concept of dignity of mankind, we have accepted fundamental rights which are given a status of being inalienable and invariable. But not 150 years back, but more than 5,000 and maybe much more than that, ancient India had given the concept of divinity of mankind.